You're listening to Popstar Conversations, taking you inside with your favorite musical artists.
This week, Chuck and I are sitting here with the timeless icon, Cher. It's truly a pleasure to have you here.
Thanks so much for coming.
First off, I have to ask you, why has it taken you 12 years to put out a new record?
Is it 12? I thought it was 11.
No, Living Proof was in 2011. Are you testing me?
No, I don't know. Yesterday people kept saying 11. This is a silly answer, but it's the truth. I just forgot. If you knew me, it would make perfect sense too. You know, and also, I was signed to Warner's UK, and Rob Dickens was the president, and he and I were very close. And when my contract ran out there, I just didn't think about Warner's America. I just, you know, it didn't occur to me that they would want to make a record. And then I was working, and then if it hadn't been for my one manager, you know, I don't think I would have done it. I thought it was just maybe too late, and the farewell album was it.
So you're telling me that they had to remind you to do another album?
Yeah. He didn't just remind me. He just said, get in the studio. This is insane.
We were told that you were doing a 60s type of cover album or a Southern rock type of album. Whatever happened to that project?
I like country music, and I like, look, I want to go do old standards at Carnegie Hall. So there's lots of things that you think about, and sometimes you do them and sometimes you just think about them.
Well, as a result, this ended up as a dance pop album. Do you still socialize in the club scene at all?
You know, I just went out because of Women's World, but it's hard because now everyone's got an iPhone. So, you know, the moment you go someplace, you know, there are horrible pictures taken of you everywhere, and they're on Twitter or Facebook immediately. So I have to pick my times. It's not easy like it used to be. Like you just run to a club and dance till your hair was wet and then go home.
Whatever happened to the song, The Greatest Thing, you recorded with Lady Gaga?
Someone just leaked it yesterday, day before yesterday. But we did it, and they didn't even leak the right version, which is really a pisser. But we did it, and then she said, I don't really like it. And I went, okay.
Let me ask you something. What was it like working with Lady Gaga?
Well, actually, she was on tour, and I came in from Las Vegas, so we didn't really work together. Plus, she wasn't working with Red One. She had worked with someone else on her album, so she didn't really want to come in. But, I mean, she seems nice enough, you know? The times I met her, she's just charming and very sweet.
Didn't you also collaborate with Pink on a couple of songs?
Well, Pink is, I mean, I know Alicia, so that's a different thing.
Cher, let me ask you about your album title, Closer to the Truth. What kind of truth are you talking about?
I'm not talking about any truth. They said come up with a working title, and there's a line in one of Alicia's songs, and it says Closer to the Truth, and I just remember, it says, and I get angry as I get closer to the truth. And I don't even know why, but the Closer to the Truth just stuck in my mind. I didn't even plan to call it that. I had no idea what I was going to call it.
After listening to this album, there's elements of, like, club goers, the empowerment of women, drag queens.
Well, hopefully it'll be a couple of other things will eke out. I mean, a couple other, maybe some men will fall in there, but yeah, I think it's, you know, club goers, and, you know, there are tracks on here that women will really love, and there are tracks on here that gay guys will love and drag queens will love. Dress to Kill, you know, drag queen dream come true.
Will you be touring this album?
Yeah, I think I will, because look, I didn't think I would come back from Farewell, because it was 3.5 years and it was just enough, you know, and it was so hard. Even though at the end, the last gig, I didn't want to stop, but I was tired and needed to break. But I won't ever tour again, because there's no way that I'm going to go out older than I am. It's too hard. Touring is just too hard. Shows are not hard, but touring is terribly hard. And I don't really like the tour part. I like the show part, I like the performance part.
Let me ask you, is there a difference between the Cher at home and the Cher on stage?
You know, the Cher that's in the public eye is kind of a magnified version of me, but I'm pretty much myself, except I'm not when I'm not working, I'm not a clothes horse anymore, truthfully. I'm just as happy to run around in sweatpants as I am in a gown, beaded gown. As a matter of fact, I'm just not even interested too much in beaded gowns. I'm more shy in my private life. I'm actually pretty shy in my private life, but in my work life, I don't have that.
So you purposely separate the two?
Because one is work, and my ideas of work are so much more well-defined. I know what I need to do in my work. I'm not hesitant. I'm not nervous to ask for what I need because I know what has to happen. And in my private life, I'm, you know, it's not like I'm not running the show. And in my private life, I kind of am much more, I'm just shy in my private life. I've always been that person. And maybe that's why I know a lot of people in my business that are very shy, and somehow this was the work they chose. Or this is the work that chose them.
So would you say after all of these years in show business that you know what's really important in life?
Well, I guess just sweating the small stuff, you know, being upset over things that you're going to forget that don't matter. I mean, my mother gave me a great piece of advice when I was young, but I kind of took it in one way, but I didn't really take it in totality of it. And that was, if it doesn't matter in 5 years, it doesn't matter. And I should remember it more often.
Cher, let's talk about the documentary, Dear Mom, Love, Cher. Is that you paying tribute to a woman that you truly admire?
Well, you know, it was a title that there were many titles that they brought, and that was the best one. It started a year before that. I made this documentary myself, a teeny little documentary for my mom's birthday. It was a birthday present. And because she had done this album, she had recorded this album when she was 50 and it got lost. And then she found it. And I took it and, you know, digital magic, took the track and, you know, brought it back to life and fixed every song. And then she wanted, I said, Mom, why don't you come to the studio and just lip sync them, and it would be really fun. And then we found a track on there that we were both doing a duet, and neither one of us remember ever recording it. We didn't even remember who wrote it. But so we did that. And so it was her 86th birthday, and I just wanted to do something special for her. And my sister said, Cher, well, she calls me stupid, you know, Mom wants these tracks done and she's found them. What do you think? And so I just kind of took over from there. And then I was editing the little, it was 18 minutes, I think. I was editing the little documentary at my house, and my agent came in because she and I are friends, and she said, this is too good just to be a birthday present. And she took it to the people at Lifetime, and they said, oh, sure, this makes sense. That's a Mother's Day special.
And what is the best advice that your mother gave you?
Well, if it doesn't matter in 5 years, it doesn't matter. And if you're going to steal something, make sure you go to jail for a long time.
I like that a lot. Cher, thank you very much for coming in. We really, really enjoyed it.
Thanks so much.
You're welcome.
Thanks again for joining us at Popstar Conversations. Make sure that you click the subscribe button below and hit the bell so that you'll be notified when our next exclusive interview with upcoming artists like Beyoncé, Miley Cyrus, and so many more are available. Thank you again for subscribing.
Thank you for listening to Popstar Conversations. Please join us again for another conversation with your favorite musical artist.